Kids, today we are making a dish called Prompt, and that's from that Fix It and Forget It recipe book that Adriana, a Argentine Shamrock, sent to me. And I believe it's the second one that I'm doing from that book. First, you want to prepare your slow cooker by spraying the inside, and then we're going to do everything by layers. This is 4 to 6 medium-sized potatoes sliced, and this reminds me actually of a recipe that I had done in the oven called Washday casserole that ended up being a fail. It you know, the rice and everything just didn't cook. It was just really gross, but I have a feeling this one's gonna work out because it says to salt and pepper each layer, so I guess just be careful. The reason why this one I think is going to work is because this here is success boil in a bag white rice. It tells you to use uncooked Bennett rice, a half to 3/4 cup. And this is why I think that it's going to work. It'll cook and I won't have to worry about that. Okay, here we have one sliced onion. Oh, I forgot to get out the beef. So I'm not going to be able to do this all in one take like I had hoped. I'll be back. Okay, so that is 1.5 pounds of ground beef. This happens to have a fairly high fat content, unfortunately. It was on sale. So I expect to open this up a little bit later and see fat just swimming around in there. So I hope you don't get too grossed out seeing that. I know I will be. Next is 1 diced green bell pepper. This is optional, but you'll understand when I add in the next ingredient as to why I decided to add it in. Okay. And last addition of salt and pepper. I would assume that there was probably about a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of pepper total that went in there. The last thing we're going to add is 1 quart of tomatoes with juice. Totally had to Google what a quart was because I was never good at math. It's 32 ounces. I bought the petite diced tomatoes and it's only 28 ounces, but I think it will be okay. There we go. That's that with that. I'm gonna cover this up. I'm gonna put it on high for 1.5 to 2 hours. So I guess we'll be back. Maybe I'll just put a little bit more of this. Okay, we'll be back. Okay, 2 hours has passed. I opted for the 2 hours versus the 1 hour. Just because I was just a little on the paranoid side and there's so much here that needs to be cooked and whatnot. But it looks like at least the rice is cooked. Let's see how this goes. Yep, the potatoes are snappy. Let's see. Yeah, the potatoes. The potatoes probably should have been cut a little bit smaller. Like that one was a little bit more pressure than this one. But it seems to have come out good. It smells good. It has a good flavor. I will let you know in a few if it tastes good. So this is called Prompt. Enjoy. The flavor is okay. If I redid it, I would say to dice your onions very small. The rice cooked up fine. The potatoes cooked up fine. The hamburger cooked up fine. The onions are, you know, because they're a little bit bigger, they're still snappy. I'm actually not sure what I would add to this to make it have a punch. But, you know, for what it is, a two-hour dinner without any work whatsoever, really? Well, lots of peeling, lots of chopping. But, I don't know. I guess it's okay. So, I'll give it a sideways thumbs instead of a thumbs up. Enjoy.